There you go.
Judging from the way they behaved Tuesday night, you might think President Obama and Governor Romney are watching Ruckus episodes for debate prep. It was an in-your-face meeting with both men circling the stage and at times each other. One of the most confrontational moments occurred when Romney questioned Obama about when or if he referred to the Benghazi attack in Libya as an act of terror.
I think it's interesting. The president just said something, which is that on the day after the attack, he went to the Rose Garden and said that this was an act of terror. That's what I said. You said in the Rose Garden, the day after the attack, it was an act of terror. It was not a spontaneous demonstration. Is that what you're saying?
Please proceed, Governor.
I want to make sure we get that for the record, because it took the president 14 days before he called the attack in Benghazi an act of terror.
Get the transcript.
He did, in fact, sir. So let me call it an act of terror.
Can you say that a little louder, Candy?
It was make or break for President Obama after a flawed performance in the first debate. A couple of polls taken Tuesday evening showed Obama the overall winner, but Romney scoring better on the top issue of the campaign, the economy. President Obama's supporters said he had to do better in the second debate to keep his campaign alive. So, Mary, how are the president's supporters feeling now as we head to another debate on foreign policy this coming Monday?
The president's supporters are elated. I mean, he's back. Where did he go? This is our guy. This is the president of the United States. This is Gary Cooper. It's high noon. And he was the president. And there wasn't anything Mitt Romney could do. He could show disrespect, rudeness, no end to challenges to the president. He not only didn't yield to him, he defended the Constitution, his program, the women of this country, and every other position that he's taken almost in his presidency with grace and strength. And as you know, this is part of what I do in life, and so I just couldn't wait for this to start. Although I help people do debate. I had to start in the kitchen because it was so scary, and I peek around the corner. I looked to see what color his tie was, to see if the tie and the suit looked good.
What color was his tie?
Red.
Yes.
And his suit fit like those great suits he always wears. And there's Romney in his 80s suit. Anyway, Mitt Romney. I think people that say that the president won, and that's everybody. If he wins the election, it will be three moments that helped him in this debate. The first was when he looked at Mitt Romney and said, "Proceed, Governor." And he was angry, but he didn't give in to his anger. He just looked him right in the eye, and Romney was physically in coming into his space. Romney physically came into Crowley's space also. The second one was when he talked about binders full of women, and that he refused to answer the question about equal pay. What a simple question, equal pay for women. And thirdly, at the final end, the president, with discipline, withheld the moment when he was going to bring up the 47% and Romney's
Romney let him into it by saying, "I'm for 100% of the people," in his closing statement. Now, I've got to move on because we're short on time. Fair to say, Romney didn't do badly, though.
Oh, well, what I think about Romney is that his behavior was totally disrespectful of the office of the president. And this is a behavior that I find appalling, not only from Romney, but from members of the Republican Party in general since President Obama has been elected. The office of the president deserves a certain level of respect, and Romney did not do that.
And I remember how they showed it to George Bush.
Ask Woody and Neil here. Can we find worse moderators than we've had for
these
debates?
Get rid of moderators.
Get rid of moderators. Terrible.
Somebody said on your old station yesterday, who's going to take this job of moderator after this? Because they've begun counting now. How many times did he interrupt Romney? How many times did he interrupt Obama?
And who got more time to speak?
The sure loser in every debate from now on is the moderator.
She had a job to get all those questions
Bob
Schieffer is doing the one on Monday. He's experienced at it. Presumably, he's going to do better. Was this a game changer, the momentum change as a result of this debate?
Well, yeah. I mean, obviously, if Obama had done poorly in this one, I think the election would have been over. I do not agree with Gwen. I don't think... I think Romney was disrespectful to the president, but I think we've seen that before. But I do think Obama did better. His answers were better. And Romney has got to explain his tax plan. But most Americans are not looking forward to the foreign one on Monday. I guess we'll see how important it actually is.